Hello everyone, today I want to talk about the integration of Dynamics 365 with Teams, the available features, and how to make users work with Teams easier. So, what I want to discuss today is the Dynamics 365 app for Teams, how it works, and how to set it up. We'll also cover appointments, how to plan them so that they appear directly in the calendar, and collaboration features like connected chats and swarm chats. Let's start with the app available in Teams. It's very simple. To install it, go to Apps. Find the app you need, which is called Dynamics 365. I don't have it in my list anymore because it's already installed, but generally it appears here. Click the Install button and it will show up. Since I already have it, we just click on it and immediately go to Settings. A quick note about the Dynamics 365 app. If you are using multiple apps in the environment, you can't display them all, only one app can be shown at a time. Here, we can choose which environment and specific app to display. If you have multiple environments, you can browse, select the app, and so on. In my dashboard, it displays the full interface of the connected app. You can work here just like in the Dynamics browser. You can create records, update records, and perform all the same actions as in the application. Of course, you need a Dynamics Enterprise license for this. A Teams license alone is not enough. Next is appointments. We can plan appointments that will immediately appear in Teams. Generally, an appointment is an activity that can be created through the timeline or activity. When creating an appointment, it's crucial to switch to Teams meeting. Some prerequisites must be set up for this to work. First, in the settings, specifically in customer service settings, you need to enable the option to create appointments with Teams meetings. Second, the user planning the appointment must have server-side synchronization configured in their mailbox settings for appointments, which includes incoming emails, outgoing emails, and appointment contacts. Without this synchronization, it won't work. For example, let's create a test demo call. We can select the time, which is shown according to the user's personal settings, Eastern time, European time, etc. This time reflects the user's settings, not the computer's settings. This is important to understand when planning time. For instance, we can set the client's time, making it easy to schedule an appointment. The client says, "Let's meet at 8," so we schedule it accordingly. We can set the start time, end time, duration, e.g. 45 minutes, add a description, and then save and close. It takes a bit of time, and the appointment with the Teams meeting will appear in the timeline, creating the call. It might take 2 to 3 minutes to show up in the calendar. I tested this before the call and it created the appointment for me. The user side sees the new appointment entry and the client or another user will receive an email with the appointment details and a Teams meeting link where they can confirm or decline. If cancelled, another email will notify about the cancellation. This tracks all changes and updates. Next is collaboration. It's very similar to the app, but we can display individual entities and directly create groups. For example, we have a customer service group and a sales group. On each entity's homepage, there's a collaborate button if it's integrated. All we need to do is click collaborate and then get started. We can search for teams. An important thing to note is the default view. If I want in progress, it will be set to in progress by default. For example, if I want to set all active cases, I click to select the appropriate view. Click Collaborate and get started. It will search for existing teams. I can select an existing team or create a new one. Let's name it Test Customer Service. Then I can make it private or public. In the second step, we select the channel where we will add this view. Again, I can create a new channel or choose General, which is the default channel created with the team. I'll choose General and finish. After that, the team and the channel are created. If we created a new channel, it's added accordingly. The view we added will appear as a new tab in the channel. We can work with this entity directly from the channel, just as we do in Dynamics. We can change views, open cases, create new cases, update them, communicate, and so on. Essentially, all the same actions we can perform in the browser, we can do directly with cases. Next is connected chats. What is the purpose of connected chats? For example, if I'm a customer service agent and need to quickly communicate with several team members, I can create a quick group chat in Teams to solve an issue. This is done very easily. We create a new connected chat. If I've communicated with other users in the timeline, they might appear as suggested participants. We can include notes from the timeline if needed. We can name the chat, for example, Hello Test Chat, or Test Chat. Relevant case information is displayed directly in the chat. Click Start Chat, and it will open in a separate window. As you can see, case information appears immediately. Alternatively, you can view it in Teams. The same information is displayed here, which is the essence of Connected Chat. And finally, I wanted to mention Swarm Chat. It's essentially the same as Connected Chat, but a bit more automated. It pulls in people, various agents, users, and managers, automatically based on certain criteria. It's integrated into customer service. After enabling it, you'll see a Create Swarm button on the ribbon. Clicking it opens the Swarm Chat form. On the left, you'll see all case information, including timeline appointments. The case title is automatically populated. There's also a section for skills, which refers to various roles such as managers or L2 support. Based on the skills, people are added to the chat. For instance, my skill is automatically pulled because there's a keyword in the title. This keyword triggers the addition of a tech manager to the chat. If we have tech issues, we need a tech manager. You can create as many skills as needed and associate them with people. Automation can then pull in skills based on keywords, adding the necessary people to the chat. You can also manually add or remove skills. For example, the keyword support might pull in a service manager. Skills can be pulled automatically based on keywords in the title or description entered by the agent, or they can be added or removed manually. When you save and send, the Swarm Chat is created in Teams. It automatically adds the relevant people, so as an agent, you don't need to worry about whom to add. The system adjusts and pulls in the necessary people to resolve the issue. That's all from me. Thank you all for your attention. Have a great day.